Dream chasers. We still gotta wake these up though. Philly, what's up?
Yeah. I'ma chase my dream. Coming to America like Prince Hakeem. I ain't never give up, but then I seen. High definition, the gift was forever given, but nothing was never given. I built this from ground up. I started out with my basement and building my house up. I'm rich off of opportunity, money gon' pile up. My swag on a 100 mil, how the stylist gon' style us. Caught up in the light. Caught up in the life. I see youngin' on the corner with a quarter of that white.
What's going on? Showed you a little bit of the facility. Today we're going to give you the full tour in there. A lot of this stuff is still up in the air, but we're going to give you just a little bit of an overview of what we're trying to do in this spot. Obviously, it's a great location. If you look out that direction, all those cars passing by back and forth on the highway. 465 is right out that direction, which 465, if you're not familiar with Indianapolis, goes around the entire city. So this building's great because it's literally 20 minutes from pretty much everywhere in the city. We're on kind of the north, a little bit west side of Indianapolis here in this spot. We're really excited about the location. We're really excited about the fact that this is a brand new building. Let's go check out what we're gonna do in here.
Okay, so we were thinking about going all the way back to this wall with our court, and we actually bought Miami, Ohio's old full court. We wanted a pro college sized floor. So for those of you that don't know, the high school floor is 84 feet long. College pro floors are 94 feet long, so they're 10 feet longer. Same width, 50 feet. So we're gonna shift the court up, and that'll give us space behind me to do lockers, benches, people can kind of come in and change that way. Court's gonna be here, and then as you back up into the space in this area, this whole area here itself is gonna be the lobby, so we'll probably put some TVs, couches, chairs, and stuff here. As we go up a little bit further, like this space here will be one kind of room that we've kind of tagged it as an office, but it'll honestly probably be more like a recovery room, so we'll put cold tanks in there, we'll do some Normatec boots. We're trying to make this kind of a state-of-the-art facility where pro guys, college guys, even all the way down to high school, middle school, can get on the court, go get their strength and conditioning, and recover all in the same building. So like that first room itself is going to be for recovery. Up against the wall over here, we'll have a couple bathrooms. We'll have another office, which will probably serve as my office here, that kind of overlooks the entire facility. So you'll have a window here, potentially a window on that side, all kind of overlooking everything out there. And then again, if you kind of walk with me here, our space goes to the second column. So as we keep walking back like that first column, now we'd obviously be walking on the floor from this side over here. So from this column to the one over there is basically 54 feet. So again, it gives us space to put that 50 foot width of a court. We're probably gonna do wall mounted hoops over on that side.
Like I would be in the middle of the floor right now. We're gonna put two hoops back here and two hoops back where people are gonna be standing. So again, like this is all gonna be wall mounted.
So again, like our space that we're going to operate out of immediately will stop right here. So if you look like that direction, I know there's a bunch of stuff over there, but like if I continue to walk back and this coop kind of stays right there. So coop standing where the court is going to stop, where our first kind of round of leasing is going to stop, or at least the area we're going to operate out of first. So from where Cooper's at all the way back to where our offices are, right about here, I know it's not hard to tell with all that stuff there. All of that space is going to be used for turf, weight room stuff, so we'll probably put turf into about this area. We haven't really measured it out yet, but about this space is where the turf would stop. We put some medicine balls, recovery, foam roller stuff, but speed, agility, a little area to do all that stuff. And then the area further back would be like squat racks, benches. And really the only other thing that we've kind of talked about and want to do, and we'll go up to the front in a second, but like on this wall back here behind me, so if any of you following us out there have ideas or thoughts or maybe want to see something out of this gym, we're going to put probably a big CG logo up on the wall, either painted or a decal. We'll do some different quotes. We're going to hang jerseys either here or up at the front of kind of all the guys that we've worked with, college, professional, you know, all those different things, and kind of keep continuing to build that jersey collection up, if you want to call it that, as we keep growing and keep adding more and more athletes to what we're doing. And then we're going to do maybe some sort of mural over on the front. I don't know how it's going to look yet, but we want to try to make this, you know, look really good, look really professional. And I think we've talked about even on like the rafters up top, and that's about a, the food shows you up top, I believe it's a 30 foot clear, so we've been looking at like 20 feet for ceilings. So obviously you want them to be high enough where you can shoot and not hit the ceiling while you're shooting at baskets, but like that 30 foot clear, and there's a little bit of a lower hanging spot up on the top part, overhang in the middle. We might start hanging like flags of different schools of guys we've worked with. So actually, like, I haven't explained this before, but some of the different hats that I wear, and obviously my long hair right now, I kind of have to wear hats, or at least I want to wear hats until I can go get it cut. But the different hats that I have are of different schools, like Coop behind the lens right now. I've got a Wittenberg hat for him, one of the best D3 schools in the nation. TCU, obviously my guy D. Bain, Kevin Easley, guys we worked with there. You know, I've got all these different colleges. I kind of started doing that a while ago when I would go on these trips and work with guys at different schools or different pro teams or whatever. I'd start trying to get hats because I always lift in hats. I wear hats when I go outside. I've always been kind of a hat guy. So I've got all these different hats. Point being, my hat collection's increasing as we're working with more and more guys. I think we're going to start trying to get flags or some sort of thing that we can hang, especially because we've got plenty of space above us where the basketballs aren't going to hit the ceiling, where it'd be kind of cool to have something hanging down, different posters, different banners, all that stuff. So it's about 7,900. I think it's going to be a little bit more than that because we're pushing the floor back, square feet that we'll operate out of. We'll keep you updated as time goes on. I think timeline right now is like the wall is going to go up next. We're kind of getting the official drawings from the architect, the official spaces on the offices here in the next couple days. And then really, I think next week, we just got kind of clarification on the fact that we can probably go ahead and put that cement down here, as you can kind of see, is like freshly poured. It's dry now, but it actually takes like 28 days for cement to actually cure fully, meaning like the moisture's out of it and it's all settled. But we can actually put the floor down as early as I think next week, and then the goals will go up, and then we're really just waiting on the permits from the state and then the city of Carmel to kind of confirm and allow us to officially operate business out of this, and then we'll be rocking and rolling. That is the full tour of the brand new CGHQ. Again, really, really pumped about it. Kind of looking at the first week of July to hopefully get those permits in place. We'll have more confirmation on that here in the near future. We'll let you know when kind of that grand opening is going to be, and we're really, really excited to have all you guys take part in this journey.
So if I make it out tonight, let's make it a bad outcome. Okay, I got it, copy. 2020, but I can't see nobody. One eye open, Illuminati. This might be the verse that make them drop me.